Hi everyone, welcome to an interview with the Revamp Edition. Once again, I've teamed up with Revamp Magazine to bring you an online interview with none other than Stacey Franks. You may know her from S Club Juniors or S Club 8, depending on where you grow up with. Hello.
Hello, how are you?
I'm good, thank you. How are you?
Yeah, I'm really good, thank you.
Good. I thought I'd come dressed appropriately today.
Yeah, you look like you straight out of S Club Juniors.
If I was old enough, I would have gone to the auditions. I was only six. When
Oh, I think you missed out by 2 years. I think you could. It is crazy to think back now that the age to audition was from 8 till,
Oh God.
I think it was 8 to th 14, I think. And Hannah was 10 when she auditioned. And when I look back now, and I think especially now because I'm a parent, I'm just like, wow, that is so young.
I
That
mean,
is
you
so young.
guys were the perfect band for me because I knew a little bit of S Club 7 because my sister was a fan.
Yeah.
But then when you guys came out, I was all that, and then by half and half, I was like, oh, I don't know who to pick now.
Oh.
So we are going to talk, of course, talk about S Club Juniors a little later on, but I want to go to the beginning. So was singing or dancing something you always wanted to do from a young age?
Yeah, from as long as I can remember. I think mum would say to me, like, you were singing when you came out of the womb. but yeah, it was definitely, as soon as I was old enough to understand, it was always been a passion of mine. I remember growing up and we lived on a little cul-de-sac, and there was like a community center next to our house. And it was like a youth, like a amateur dramatics thing.
Wow.
And it was £1 every Friday. And we did like musical theatre. So we did like The Wiz, we did Sound of Music,
Oh,
Carousel, all of those. And then my mum and dad quickly were like, well, she's actually really good at this. And I remember, I think I mean, I must have been about probably about 7, 8, and I always used to get the main part, and I was the youngest there, so I was playing, like, I got cast as Julie Jordan
wow.
in Carousel, and there's little me, and then everyone else was like in their late teens, and they're just like little old me.
Oh.
But yeah, so that's like my first kind of experience performing on stage. And then I was a massive Spice Girls fan. I see you've got a Spice Girls poster in the background
Oh,
there.
that
That way. And I was always Mel B. I don't know why. Well, I think you can guess
Same, same. She
that.
was always my favorite from being young anyway, because I just loved her outfits and like her hair and everything, just incredible.
So Spice Girls, when they came out, I was like, that's what I want to do. I want to be a pop star. And I was like, I will be a pop star one day. Mum was like, I have full faith in you, and you definitely. My mum said to me, she always knew that something would happen. Did like the school plays, school concerts, just everything that I could do. And then I think, well, I was 12 when I auditioned for S Club. I was a massive S Club 7 fan. And actually, I think we auditioned like to the back end of the year. And for my birthday the next year, I wanted to go see them in concert. That was what I asked for. And then I used to go to like this singing thing, and the woman who owned it said, "Oh, have you seen the order? They're auditioning for like a mini S Club." And I auditioned because if you got through to the finals, you got to meet S Club 7. So that was like the driving force behind me auditioning. I was like, I don't stand a chance. But if I can get to the finals, then I'll be able to meet S Club 7.
That's
So yeah,
incredible.
I remember I auditioned at the Lowry in Manchester, and literally went there. My hair was still wet. I didn't. I It was actually so early that I was like, I think I'm just gonna leave it. Could you imagine if I did? How
Yeah.
difficult that
You wouldn't be
would
here
be.
now. You wouldn't be able to have all that fame and get to perform with S Club on tour and
Isn't it incredible? And I went, and I remember being in the queue, and there's all these like professional dancers, like in their proper like dance shoes and stuff like that, and they're all like stretching and warming up, and I was just
Oh
like,
God.
what are they doing? Like, got no idea. And yeah,
So
it was just,
You've actually answered three of my questions.
Have I? Just tell me to shut up.
No, it's fine. Because one of my questions was, did you have any inspirations in music growing up? And of course, you mentioned Spice Girls, which is
Yeah.
incredible. And then, because we know you best for being in S Club Juniors,
Yeah.
you've answered how that happened, which it was on a show called S Club Cert on BBC, I believe.
Yeah, so before X Factor, before Pop Idol, before all that, we had S Club Search.
Yeah.
And it was like a mini like X Factor.
Because wasn't it, if I remember correctly, I think your first ever appearance with them was doing on Children in Need.
Yeah, so originally if you got in the band, it was to perform on Children in Need with S Club 7
Yeah.
and support them on their tour. And that was all it was meant to be. I don't know if many people know that. That was where it was meant to stop. So
Yeah.
just that, you know, that was the prize. And then I think, you know, it was received really well.
Yeah.
And like, yeah, we're gonna, you know, we're gonna do an album deal. And then that was it. And then that was it for the next 4 years. I moved home, I moved out of my house,
Yeah.
12, taken out of school. And moved home, which was, I think that was probably the hardest thing, was being away from my family and very close
Yeah.
to family.
Oh.
Moved down to London and have never been back home. And now I'm almost 34. So,
Wow.
yeah.
I'm 27, going on 28 in June, and
Oh.
when S Club was around, I was only little, so I
Yeah.
literally was that close to missed
I
out
know.
on the auditions. I would have
Oh,
loved
bless
it.
you. Yeah. Yeah,
It would have been
do you like
incredible.
singing?
Yeah,
Did you
I used
sing?
to do what you did. I used to go to like musical
Yeah.
theatre lessons and
Oh,
stuff and
amazing.
drama. I did performing
Yeah.
arts at college,
Yeah.
where I was still obsessed with S Club 7 and S Club Juniors, even though you were no longer a band.
Yeah.
So, was there any S Club Junior songs or S Club 8 songs you wish could have been singles? Because personally, I love Rush.
I
You
know, yeah,
know.
you mentioned Rush. Yeah, Rush was an absolute tune. I'm just trying to think now. I love Big Fun. That was obviously a cover, but I
Yeah.
love we I speak for myself, but I love that song. I think Don't Tell Me Sorry. For some reason, they made it into a dancier version, the
I
one that
prefer that version to the album
you
version.
actually.
Yeah.
So when that was obviously the last song we released as a band, and
Yeah.
when we heard the demo for Don't Tell Me Sorry, we were like, oh my God, this is R&B. It's not R&B, but we thought it was R&B. And we were like, oh yeah, it's really cool. Like we sound really grown up. You know, and we were all getting older and we were like, maybe we'll be taken a little bit more seriously with this song. And then they were like, yeah, we're gonna make it into a dance song instead. And I do love it, but I wish that they would have kept it as the
Yeah.
album version, because I know that we all preferred that version.
Yeah.
And then I think, what else? I'm trying to think now. I was actually listening. We got stuck in traffic on the M6 coming home from London the other day, and there was a lorry crash, and we were in the same position
Oh.
5 hours at like 2 o'clock in the morning. And my husband had fallen asleep, and I just put S Club Junior albums on, and I just listened to every single song that we've ever done. And it's nice to do that sometimes.
Yeah.
It's so nostalgic and brings back so many like wonderful memories for me.
Can just imagine you in the car doing
Yeah,
the automatic
honestly,
car routine.
I've got no shame whatsoever. No shame. I Come Alive. That I think that's the one that I wish we would have
Yeah.
released. I Come Alive.
That is a good song.
It's just happy, and yeah, I love that song.
I think for me, from Together, I think what I used to like it. I still do, but not as much anymore. One Fine Day.
One Fine Day, yeah, that's a great song. Yeah,
It's like totally obscure from the album.
I know. I think it was like a B-side on one of the singles, if I'm remember rightly. But that's a cover as well, and I
Yeah.
hear that song quite a lot, the original. I remember being in a shop once. I think it was Tiger, and our version came on, and I was just in Tiger. Like I still remember all the dance routines; they're just like embedded into my brain, and they just never go away.
So recently, we've seen you go back to your S Club roots by joining Tina and Bradley for S Club All Stars. What's that been like, and how did that happen?
Oh, it's been incredible. So this is how it happened. So there was not last year, the year before, they were doing the 90s tour and they were playing in Manchester. And my friend, she couldn't go. She said, do you want my ticket? S Club, Tina and Bradley are playing. And I went along and I bumped into an old agent of mine, Matt. And he used to look after me when I came off of X Factor, and we stayed friends. And I was just saying to him, I was like, oh my God, I was like, I just wish we could do something together. Like, I think it would be amazing. And we had toyed with the idea in the past. It never really came to life. And then a week after, I had a phone call from Steve, who is Bradley's dad, lovely Steve, and he's our manager and agent, manager
Oh,
stroke.
wow.
And he gave me a call. He was like, "Hi, Stacey, Steve Bradley's dad. Matt said he saw you the other week, and we just wondered if you'd be interested in joining Brad and Tina. We've had an idea, S Club All Stars, like an S Club party. We'll do S Club songs, S Club Junior songs." And I was like, "Yep. You don't need to play anymore. I'm in." And originally we were like, we just wanted to test the water, see if it would actually work. And then last year, like, I don't think there was a week where we weren't gigging. We traveled all over the world. We went to
Wow.
Dubai, we went to Stockholm, we went to Norway, just all these amazing places.
Wow.
And just to be back on stage doing what I love,
Yeah.
sharing it with Brad and Tina, because obviously, we've got a lot of history and they're really great friends of mine.
Yeah.
Just the fact that people are still paying to watch us perform, which is
Yeah.
crazy, like all these years after. But it's just like those like 30 minutes that we're on stage, it's
Yeah.
just like I feel like I'm back in the band. The songs are amazing. I love that I'm able to like sing and perform S Club 7 songs, because I know every single song, I know every single dance. When we first got together, we had a little rehearsal and they were like, "Yeah, so we'll teach you this." And I was like, "You don't have to teach, you don't
You
have to
already
teach,
know it.
I know it." Because we, from our time in the band on tour, we would support them and then we would watch the show.
Yeah.
Every song, every harmony, every dance move. And yeah, I was like, I already know it all. So no need to teach me.
Love to see how Tina and Bradley would perform One Step Closer and Sundown and
Oh yeah, so they actually do like backing vocals when I'm singing. We do One Step and Automatic High. We don't do that, we don't dance, but they're kind of like, do we do like the the S Club songs, we do dance routines too. But yeah, with my songs, because I'm singing the whole song, it's very difficult to
Yeah.
dance as well. But yeah, they sing it with me, and it is just like it's amazing to look out into the crowd.
Yeah.
And sometimes I'm just like, well, everybody knows who S Club 7 are. And
Yeah.
sometimes I'm like, well, you had to have been a fan really to know who we
Yeah.
were. And still now, every time I'm going on stage, I'm like, have we got any S Club Junior fans in the house? And I just like expect nothing back.
Yeah.
And it's just so nice to hear people and to watch people singing along to the songs and to be doing the dance routines. And I just love it.
Was about to say, if I ever go to a gig, I guarantee I'll be in the front row doing every single
Oh
routine.
yeah. I hope you will be. I hope
I
you will
hope you
be.
get me on stage, I'll be
I'll
singing.
get you up on stage. Honestly, there's always one person at the shows that's like stands in the aisle and they're like, make eye contact with me, and they do the full out routine. And I'm just like, that's incredible. Is it? And
I'll be wearing this on stage with you.
yeah, no, honestly, I love it. I love it. We'll have to make you your own little S Club Junior jacket. I've still got
The
mine.
6-year-old be screaming right now, thank you.
Yeah. We'll see.
Now, there are rumors circulating that S Club 7 is set to get back together after celebrating 25 years.
Yeah.
Is there a chance the juniors would ever do the same?
Personally, I would love to. I don't think it will happen.
Okay.
If I'm being honest.
Yeah.
Just everybody's, you know, got their careers and families and all over the place. And I hold out hope that maybe we could do maybe like a one show.
Yeah.
But it needs to have everybody for it to work. I don't think there's much point in doing it unless there's all eight of us. Some are more keen than others.
Yeah.
But yeah, I think it just depends. It has to be the right time for everybody to want to do it. But I personally, I mean, everybody knows that I would absolutely love to do just one little show.
Even if so that means
that's all I'm asking for.
Stretching into your old S Club Juniors jacket for one more time.
I know. And you know what? I don't know if everybody else has got theirs. I'm sure they have, because it's such an amazing thing to keep.
Yeah.
My daughter walks around the house in mine.
Oh, that's cute.
I know that Aaron did a shoot with Owen with ReVamp, and I thought that he'd got like the clothes made, but the actual original clothes in the shoot. And I was like, how do they still fit you? And the jacket, the picture on, I think it was the cover picture, and he's got the jacket on, and it's literally like up here. The arms are like up here. Because he's, you know, he's a lot more muscly than he used to be.
Yeah.
But yeah, it is. It's one of those things that I'll cherish forever.
If you need an extra member to gig, let me know.
Like, I'll let you know.
You've got my number, so you know.
Yeah, I will do. If no one wants to reunite, then me and you can just do it.
I don't think I can sing as high as the original key.
Yeah, you can take it down.
I don't mind, honestly,
you're at the top of the list if I need anyone.
I don't mind banging out Puppy Love now and again on stage.
There we go.
Oh, God. Yeah, that'd be quite fun. I can just imagine myself now just like push you to one side and be like taking off.
Yeah, you do it. You take the stage.
So my last question to you, Stacey.
Yeah.
What does the future hold for you?
Oh, well, I hope to continue gigging with Brad and Tina, Escobar All Stars.
Yeah.
We do have a couple of gigs lined up throughout the year. Not too sure what's happening with the reunion. I can't confirm nor deny that they will be reuniting, but I hope they do. And I'm going to be going to all of the shows if they do. And I'll be like, can I come up on stage? I'm joking, I wouldn't do that.
I'll be doing the same thing as you.
Just to continue performing. I just want to be on stage. That makes me happy. I'm a mum now, so that is my main priority. So
yeah.
If I can stay on stage and still look after my daughter, then that's just like the perfect scenario for me. So just want to perform. That's all I want.
Okay, so we've got a little lyrics game for you now.
Woo! Go on.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
So I'm going to do some lyrics from either some S Club songs or S Club Junior songs. Let me say which one's which, but I'm just going to let you listen to...
So do I have to guess the name of the song?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, go on.
So, well, I'm going to say some lyrics from the S Club song or S Club Junior. So you've got to finish the lyrics.
All right, go on.
You can either sing them or just speak them. I'm speaking them because I can't sing to save my life.
Okay.
So the first one... Are you ready?
Yeah.
I hope you'll get this.
It'll be embarrassing.
So this is the lyric. No one's moved me in this way before. It's all so brand new. Finish the lyric.
I know what song it is. I'm just trying to think. Oh, my God. What is that? Because that's not my lyric. That's the second verse, isn't it?
That's why I did it.
Me in this way before, it's all so brand new. I don't know what it is. It's not. No one's with me this way before. It's all so brand new. Yeah. Wait, is it you got me so? You got me? Is that right?
Yeah.
You got me? Wait. This way for so I honestly, it's gone. I can't. How embarrassing is that? It's
So
because it's because that's not my. It's not
yeah.
my verse. That's what you've done. You're trying to throw me off.
So
so I don't know where I am or what I'm gonna do.
Yes, well done. I knew you'd get it. Oh, that was quite cute, actually. I'm not gonna lie. He was like, "I forgot it." Oh no! All Eskil Junior fans are gonna be like, "She don't remember no more. She's too now. She don't remember."
She's too old. That's it. She's too old now. She's lost
Okay.
the memory.
So this is the second lyric. You should get this one because I think this is, if I remember rightly, this is your lyrics. So, you shouldn't lie. You shouldn't play, not the kind of girl to look the other way. Finish the lyric.
This, why is this so hard? Is it, I'll be looking for a new direction? Or is there
Close.
another bit?
There's another bit.
So you shouldn't lie. You shouldn't have played. Not the kind of girl to look the other way. It's.
Oh
No, it's not.
no.
Does it
Yes.
repeat?
Yeah, but it's you shouldn't cry, you shouldn't faint. Just got to tell you straight before I walk away.
Gotta tell you straight before I walk away.
There we
It's
go.
too late.
You've just given me all kinds of goosebumps. Like, you sound exactly the same. What?
No, my
That's
voice hasn't changed
incredible.
at all. At all.
Oh, that's amazing. So I'll give you the point for that because you did remember it. And you did the routine, which was really
So do
cute.
I get an extra point for that then?
Yeah, I'll give you one. Okay, so this is the third lyric. So we've got this one and then I've got two more.
Okay.
I hope you get this one. You took me up, drew me in like a moth to your flame. Put your jinx in a deadly kiss. Your body locked me down in chains. Finish the lyrics.
Yeah. James. I get confused with which verse. That's the first verse. I know. Tell me that you drew me in like a moth to your flame. Put your chains in a delicate shot, lock me down in chains. Is it didn't? Did a read.
Yeah.
The day sighs to you crept into my mind. Made me believe you were so in love. I was mesmerized.
Oh yeah, you got that. Well done.
Yes.
That's good. Okay, so this is another lyric, but
Okay.
this one isn't S Club Juniors.
All
So we're
right.
going to S Club now.
Oh, okay, go on.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
It's a crazy world where everything's changing. One minute you're up, and the next thing you're breaking. Finish the lyrics.
Oh my God. Say it again.
So it's a crazy world where everything's changing. One minute you're up, and the next thing you're breaking.
Don't know.
So this, I'll give you the song. So this is Two in a Million.
Oh, okay. One video of the breaking. Is it the verse or is it the
It,
bridge? Is
it's
it
the
the bridge?
verse. Yeah.
Is it in a crazy world? No.
That's I've just said that.
Say it again.
So it's a crazy world where everything's changing. One minute you're up, and the next thing you're breaking.
Is it just well?
There's a bit more. Shall I give? I'll give you the next part of it to help.
Well, on yeah.
So when I lose my way, and the skies
I
they get
take
heavy.
it heavy. Lose my way. The skies take it heavy. It'll be okay as long as you're with me.
Yeah, I'll give you that one.
Yeah. That was hard. 2 in a Million, that's such a tune as well.
That is one of my favorites as
Such
well.
a tune. And I love You're My Number One. That was my what I sang for my first audition. So
Oh.
that's one of my favorites.
Oh. So I'm going to give you the last lyric. Are you ready?
I've got to get this. Come on, I can't not get this.
So this one should be familiar to you because I think you performed this on Top of the Pops with them. You did like an
Okay.
SW United type thing,
I
like a Mega Mix sort of
that's
thing.
what it's going to be.
So, I just can't stop the feeling. What you give is what I'm needing. Finish the lyrics. Would it be better if I sang it to you?
Yeah, no, because that makes it easy and I want to get it. Right, repeat, sing, say it again.
I just can't stop the feeling. What you give is what I'm needing.
When you say can't stop the feeling, I just think of Justin
Yeah.
Timberlake.
Do you want to sing it for you?
On, sing it.
I just can't stop
Oh,
feeling.
yeah. This is what I'm needing, what I'm needing. Just again, it's really low. On and on, it's only just begun. I'm feeling so alive.
I'll give you that one. Because if I remember rightly, you sing a New Direction and then it goes into
Yes, it
Alive.
was. Was it? Was that? Was it? I for some reason, I feel like that was Smash Hits Award. No, Disney. No. That I'm thinking they're completely something different
It
there.
might have been Smash Hits.
We did, yeah. So we did New Direction and then it went into Alive and
Yeah.
then it came on and then yeah, I remember that. That was great. Love
I
that.
just remember one of the Top of the Pops performances where you're all on stage and Joe Bless is on a little podium behind you all.
Oh, bless her. Oh, I think that's because she's had problems with the back,
Yeah.
hasn't she? But yeah. Oh gosh, she's amazing though, isn't she? Like her voice is
Yeah.
just incredible.
One thing I wish would have
So
happened, I don't know, I've not seen it in years, so I don't remember, but in Scene Double, I don't think you make an appearance. As
no, we
extra.
don't. Yeah, that's right. I think the only I remember we made an appearance in one of the TV shows
Yeah.
in Barcelona. So what would that have been then? What was that called? That
That was
one.
Viva S Club.
Viva S Club, yeah. And we I remember it's that. What's that road? That famous road in Barcelona.
Oh, yeah. I'm trying to think. I can't think of the name now.
Yeah, and we were there filming for our TV show, which was
I
a,
dream.
no, it was
Oh.
no, it was that was it was way before Our Dream. It was so we had S Club Search, and then it wasn't called what was it called after S Club Search? S Club Story.
Ah, okay.
Remember that? So we just like the camera, it was just like a documentary thing. Cameras followed us on our journey. So yeah, we went over to Barcelona and we were pretending to be fans of S Club. And we just like run up to them and be like, can we have a photo? Can we have an autograph? Yeah. So that was our little cameo in there.
I don't
No,
think you were pretending there.
it wasn't. We weren't.
Yeah.
And I would all like no matter how many times we saw them, I would always be like so in awe of them,
Yeah.
so like starstruck. But yeah, so yeah, Our Dream was it 2004, 2003 to 2004. But yeah, and that sadly was like the last thing we did as well.
I sort of remember I Dream because I can remember it being on CBBC quite a lot.
Yes,
But I think it's because I always thought it would be something similar to S Club 7, what they did. So I just thought it'd be you guys. And then when this whole cast came in, I was like, whoa.
So I think we thought that as well, because we actually played ourselves.
Yeah.
But it wasn't ourselves. And then the cast that they brought in, actually, fun fact for you here, Lorna Want, who played, what was her name in it now? What was her name in it now? The blonde girl who was like,
yeah,
I don't remember her name in it now. But anyway, she auditioned for S Club Juniors. And when we auditioned, there was an A group and a B group. So the A group was planned, and then the B group, they were kept on file, so for future projects. And then she ended up being called for that job. Isn't that funny? And she's in the West End now. I think she played Carole King in Beautiful.
Wow.
But she's incredible, yeah. But yeah, so we actually thought it would be a little bit different too, to what it actually was. Mm. But yeah, it's a strange one, but we loved it. So
I think I do remember seeing it, and I remember Frankie and Calvin did the theme song.
Yeah, so Dreamin', they released that as them two.
Yeah.
To promote I Dream, and I think that's just kind of like where it fizzled out, unfortunately.
Yeah. I think an Escalade version would have been better.
Yeah, because we did hear about maybe a second season, but yeah, it just kind of like ended like quite abruptly. And they released Dreaming from Avalon Heights album, and then that was it. But it's sad.
It's nice to hear that you're still so passionate about your time in S Club Juniors and begin now. Because I know that most people who used to be in like bands when they were younger don't tend to like talk about it more or...
Yeah, and I think I get that.
Yeah.
But for me, it's such a big part of my life and such an amazing time and an amazing experience. Like, how can I not?
Yeah.
I owe everything to that band and that time. So for me, I'm happy to talk about it and relive it. And, you know, I love the nostalgia. But yeah, I can see that some people would maybe want to stray away from it a little bit because they want to be known for what they do now. And I get that, but that'll never be me. So I'm going to be performing in All Stars when I'm old and grey. I mean, I am old and I am grey. But you know what I mean? When I'm like in my 80s, I'll still be on stage.
Just as I'm afraid.
Singing Automatic High. Imagine.
I can imagine that actually.
Yeah.
The future's like now, so they'll probably give you a hologram, get a hologram of you on stage.
That's it. I'll be in my nursing home, like Abba, whatever it is, Abba Voyage or whatever it is. Have you seen that?
I don't think I have.
No, Abba, the tour.
Oh, yeah. Sorry, yeah. Yeah, the that could be quite fun. Having an S Club Juniors style hologram thing.
Maybe if we did a hologram, then everyone would do it.
Yeah.
We'll see. I'll ask.
Just do what they did, do like in mocap suits, performing all the songs for the gig, and then have you all dressed in your denim jackets when you were younger, and then evolve from to S Club 8. But see, I'm thinking now.
Ideas. I think me and my agent Matt, we're talking about maybe me going out and doing an S Club Junior thing and having some dancers. So
hi.
Hi, here you are. You can audition for me now if you want.
Oh God, I can't really. You can't really see the full shot. I'm in my jammers. I've just got this.
Well, I've got no trousers on, so just from the waist up, I'm dressed. Nothing else underneath.
Oh, this is amazing. We're just having a conversation now, guys. Yeah, I'll definitely audition for you when we've stopped filming. because I don't want YouTube to see that.
send me a spotlight link and your show reel, and I'll have a look.
I don't have either of those.
and I'll be in touch.
Don't call us, we'll call you.
Yeah.
That means no. I am actually thinking of doing like an S Club Juniors sort of thing for drag soon. So,
oh my god! Actually, Owen said that that we could talk about Drag Race. I'm a massive, massive Drag Race fan. My husband actually bought me tickets to go see them in Manchester. I think is it in April or either April or August? I can't remember. But I've seen every single season. I've seen all the different countries. Italy one, the Thailand one, Canada one, all of them, Spanish one, is there a Denmark one, isn't that? All of them, massive fan. Who is your favourite, have you got a favourite drag queen?
Oh, yeah, you're making me think now.
There are so many, aren't there?
I used to be a fan of one drag queen, but since everything like horrible came out about this drag queen, I'm no longer a fan.
Bought them, yeah.
Yeah, it's when I met them. I will tell you once we've stopped the interview, but I don't want people coming back to me like.
No, you don't have to say. Don't worry.
No, but yeah, I met this certain queen a couple of years. Well, about 3 years ago now, and she was lovely, couldn't fault her. But then everything came out about this queen, and I was like, oh my god, like, and I was such a fan.
Yeah. Like, No one is safe nowadays with social media, unfortunately. Every bad thing you do will eventually come back to haunt you in one way or another, and you can't hide. So be a good person, okay? That's all you need to do. Well, and then you won't be cancelled.
No, that's true.
It's really not that hard. Just be a good person, okay?
Well, Stacey, thank you so much for being a guest on today's episode.
Thank you for having me. It's been lovely.
It's been like talking to a friend that I've known for years. It's been very very easy to talk to you and ask you about S Club Juniors.
Well, it's been lovely. Thank you so much for having me.
If you want to follow Stacey on social media, I will put the links below. Yes, get that promo. I'm just gonna be doing that for like 5 minutes now. Swipe up, link in bio.
You plug the hell out of me, please.
And if you want to follow me, that's okay, you can. I'll put my links in the description below. And thank you again, Stacey, and I will see everyone on the next episode.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome. Bye. Closer to heaven, baby.